trying to get to it. When you think about the slope like this, in that middle slope are the Premier Cru and Grand Crus. And I think one of the things that people forget about Burgundy, you know, we talk about the deep, dark secret is we're a continental climate. And we're at the 47th parallel. We're northern Maine. We're Seattle. And so think about June 21st on the slope at 4 o'clock in the afternoon. The sun is straight up in the air, straight up in the sky. All the vineyards are getting sun. It's fantastic. Lots of sunshine. At 4 o'clock in the afternoon on September 21st, where is the sun? It's low in the horizon. Which vineyards are still getting sunshine at 4 o'clock in the afternoon? The mid-slope. Not the village and the Bourgognes below or above. It's the mid-slope, the Premier Crus and the Grand Crus. And this is what we forgot or never learned in 10th grade biology class, photosynthesis, turning the starches into sugars, the chlorophyll. And so we don't think in terms of temperature hours as they do in the more southern climates. We think in terms of how many hours of luminosity, sunshine, to convert the starches into sugars. And so I make the point maybe a little too hard. I said, so let's go to the Willamette Valley. It's very cool from the Atlantic, from the Pacific Ocean. It can get nice and hot in the summer, but you're at the 45th parallel. That's the Rhone, okay? That's just south of Hermitage. Then you go to Napa, it's Barcelona. Sonoma's Barcelona on a latitude basis. But again, I don't want to overstate the fact, it gets cool because you have the Pacific breezes that cool as Sonoma, makes for delicious Pinot Noir and Chardonnay. But those grapes are going to get a lot more sunshine and get a lot riper than ours can. And then you go down to Santa Barbara, you're in Tunisia. Again, it's cool, but they're going to get riper. So we have two different problems. In California, they get lots of sunshine, so the sugars shoot through the roof, and the acids get burned up by the sugar. We have the opposite. We have high acids, low sugar. So we're trying to bring those two together to get them in better balance. And so between that and the fact that we have limestone, you know, we have a different flavor profile than anywhere else in the world for the Pinot Noir and Chardonnay. And it's our, you know, it's what makes it wonderful when it's great, but also it's our biggest biggest challenge we have every year is to try to get these grapes ripe. And the last 4 years, they've been marginal growing years, very difficult. A lot of overcast, cold spring, bad flowering, all these kinds of things. So we're constantly, you know, working the vineyards, aerating, pulling leaves off to get better aeration, more exposure for the bunches to try to get these bloody grapes ripe. Because every day after June 21st, it's a slippery slope. You know, can we catch up for sunshine with the sunshine? And that's really what it comes down to. Lost.